instrument of common peace in war times. This video is titled Atonism, Ankhenaton, His Spirit, and Young Pharaoh. All right, I've been meaning to make this video for some time, but my schedule didn't permit it. So now I got some time to go into that, and we're going to break a lot of this stuff down. I said many a times that Mr. Pharaoh was possessed by the spirit of Ankhenaton, not Ankhenaton himself, but the spirit that possessed Ankhenaton after the Pharaoh passed. Spirits transmigrate from body to body, and Pharaoh was possessed and chosen by that particular spirit from the 18th dynasty. So we're going to get into that as we move forward. All right. It's the symbol of life, the Newt symbol, the colors in the electromagnetic spectrum. NEY61, Newport Embryo, year 97, 5/29/2023 by Ju Satuna Tar Keno Uno Nupu, Black Justice 9 Foundation. Who was Moses by race and religion? Moses was Phoenician. The Phoenicians were called Hebrews before the Jews adopted the terms. The Phoenicians are not original Egyptians, but a people who had supplanted the Ethiopians of Egypt in much the same way that the Jews, other Greeks, and the Romans supplanted the Phoenicians. The Phoenicians originally came from Asia and were invaders of Egypt themselves around 3000 BC. Moses was a ruler of Egypt and his title was Thutmose I. He was the beginning of the Moon Dynasty in Egypt around 1600 BC. Bible Interpretation and Explanations, Book 2, Number 21, written by Aminubi Rakapatar, 1968. Listen to Sound Right Cosmic Reason. Let's define who are the Phoenicians according to noon science, historically and in mundane science. Listen to reason. The preceding information about the Ptahkind race is why it is well known in Africa and the ancient world in general that the only true king was an African king of Ptahkind descent. And this is also why when the Phoenician kings were ruling in the ancient Egypt and their royal lineage of heirs ran out, they were sent to Nubia for a Nubian prince to come and start up their regal lineage of heirs again by sitting on the throne and producing a male future heir by one of their Phoenician females. Excuse me. Introduction to the Nature of Nature, Book 2, page 112, in part written by Afra Uno. Monkey was first ape-man people along the chimpanzee order of primates, and they finally evolved from the anthropoid ape-man and ape-woman into erectopus. That is to say, modern man called the Phoenician race. The Phoenician race are people like Arabs, Spaniards, Turks, and Latinos. It is true that modern man, the Ankhenaton races, evolved from ape man and not anthropoid ape, meaning modern man was created as ape man from the start. Pages 113, 115, and 117 ahead, and this topic depicts somewhat what members of the human races look like at their origins, and shape 31 and 35 on pages 68 and 70 show their origin points as explained and described in the following paragraphs. Let it be remembered always well. Introduction to the Nature of Nature, Book 2, page 109, in part written by Afra Uno. Listen to Sanre Cosmic Reason. Let's look at some points. One, the Phoenician race are people like Arabs, haplogroup E, Spaniards, Turks, and Latinos. This writer, Mary Tarkino Uno Nupu, Black Communication 9 Foundation, adds another group of people to this list called the Berbers, haplogroup J. Both groups are genetically linked. The phylogeography of Y chromosomes, haplogroup E, and J, haplogroup J, was investigated in 2,400 subjects from 29 populations, mainly from Europe and the Mediterranean area, but also from Africa and Asia. The observed 501 haplogroup E and 445 haplogroup J samples were subtyped using 36 binary markers and 8 microsatellite loci. Spatial patterns and reveal that one, the two sister clades JM267 and JM172 are distributed differentially within the Near East, North Africa, and Europe. Two, JM267 was spread by two temporarily distinct migratory episodes, the most recent one probably associated with the diffusion of Arab people. Three, EM81 is typical of Berbers and is presence in Iberia and Sicily is due to recent gene flow from North Africa. The Berbers them came down from Iberia, I think from the Horn of Africa and North Africa into our continent, Africa. All right, this is where you can go look this up yourself. Origin, diffusion, differentiation of Y, chromosome haplogroups E and J, etc., etc. Are Berbers and Arabs genetically similar? North African populations are very heterogeneous and are composed of North African, Middle Eastern, Sub-Saharan, and European genetic components. No genetic differences have been found between Arab and Berber groups. The Arab expansion and an important culture and genetic impact in North Africa. The Phoenician Arabs and Berbers were the actual Egyptians ruling Kemet in the 18th dynasty and are still there today as Muslims. The Meshwar, often abbreviated in ancient Egyptian as Ma, was an ancient Libyan Berber tribe along with other groups with Libu and Tihinu. Early records of the Meshwar date back to the 18th dynasty of Egypt from the reign of Amenhotep III. 1390 to 1350 BC. To the left, you have Arab invaders called Egyptians today. All right, next is a famous statue with this particular male here. And a lot of people would say that these are Egyptians and they try to solidify African people as being in Kemet at this time, but when you do further analysis, you find that this is not true. All right, so left is a Kayan Misnui, minister of agriculture, reign of Pharaoh Teti, the sixth dynasty, 2345 BC. Right is a Beja gentleman of Northeast Africa. All right, so now we finna really get into it. All right, say the Beja tribe male, who are also mistaken as woolly-haired Ethiopian African people due to the hair above, many think he is African. However, if you look closely, you will see his hair is not kinky at all, but curly and matted down, which means that the statue is not a woolly-haired Ethiopian African. The Beja tribe is from the haplogroup E1B1BJ. They share strong genetic relations to the Eritreans, who are haplogroup E1B1J. Remember when we came up here, when it talks about the Arabs and the Berbers, right? They fall under, you see the J? The two sister clades, JM267 and JM172 are distributed. So you got the J, all of them is under that J, but it's different subgroups of that. All right, so again, when you look at his hair, I'm gonna make it bigger. When you look at it, it's curly, and it looks like whatever they use to keep it curly is the stuff that's on top of it. But that's not African kinky hair. All right. Yes, we mix with different races of melanated people, but they didn't get the full transfer of the kink, and you're gonna understand why this is so important. That we make a differentiation between dark-skinned people with curly hair and not kinky hair versus, you know, these people who they're trying to portray as Africans, because these people migrated into our country, our continent, thousands of years ago, it mixed in and eventually invaded certain important spaces such as Kemet. All right, so this guy here is not African. All right, because your hair is the ultimate universal marker. All right, listen to reason. The Eritreans also fall into the category of a branch of the Phoenician race as well. The Eritreans are falsely called Ethiopians due to their location or migration. All right, see, notice all this stuff is close by. Saudi is right here, Sudan, Eritrea, Ethiopia. Remember, the whole of Africa used to be called Ethiopia at one time. But we're going to get into why this is important at this moment in time. Eritreans are the native inhabitants of Eritrea, as well as the global diaspora of Eritrea. Eritreans constitute several component ethnic groups, some of which are related to ethnic groups that make up the Ethiopian people in neighboring Ethiopia and people groups in other parts of the Horn of Africa. What is the difference between Eritreans and Ethiopians? There's no major cultural or ethnic difference between the people of Eritrea and Ethiopia. The difference is mainly political, and it all started when Eritrea remained a colony of the Italians after the at-war victory Ethiopia had over Italy at 1896. There are differences between Eritreans and Ethiopians, the African kinky hair race. The African race are in haplogroups L2, L3, L4, haplogroup EM2, AK4, and E1B1A1-M2. Here are some famous people you may know who are Eritreans but pass as black African Americans but are not. Seven famous people you didn't know are from Eritrea. R&B singer Jay Holiday. Not African or Ethiopian black. This is another picture of Mr. Holiday. Notice the curls in the next picture. So when you look deep into it, you can see that it's curled. It's curly. It's not kinky. All right. These are the basic hair types of Eritreans. Eritreans, all right? We have to relearn who we are and stop others from infiltrating our culture and pretending to be us and benefit from doing so. All right, next, how Nipsey Hussle connected to his Eritrean roots.
We're gonna catch a vibe tonight, Houston. Double lie, three or four times. I ain't telling no lies. I swear to God, never let a one time double lie. I ain't telling no lies. I just five, four, three, two. That's right. I cry to you, bad boy. My dreams. Turn 7 to a 4J, 4J to a whole day.
Lord knows it's a cold game. Switch it up on you, Jose. Big body tank, both flex. Backseat, we're on propane. All black, fire, gold chains. Young rich nigga bossed up on his own, man. My new shit sound like a soul train. Tookie Williams on the cold train. Eric B by the road chain. RSC, we can show back. Tiny notes and they go crazy. What you know about the dope game? Was you born in the 80s? Did your mama smoke cocaine? Have you ever seen a whole day? Was you drunk to the streets cause you grew up on show chain? Fucked up with the dope bass. It reminds me when these rappers drop guns and they close chains. At the park with the low fade. I was standing in front of niggas with my sack for the whole day. Drop lines, that was road rage. Then we parked and hopped out, learned levels to this whole thing. Old school, play the OJ, trying to make it slow change. Mama still sleeping for a low wage. Trying to double up.
What kind of African was Nipsey Hussle? Nipsey Hussle was born Aramaeus Aramis Joseph Asgedom in the Crenshaw District of South Los Angeles, California on August 15, 1985. His mother, Angelique Smith, an African-American woman from L.A., and father, Dawit Asgedom, an Eritrean immigrant, are alive and currently live in LA, according to this article, March 31st, 2022. Listen to reason. Although Aramis, rest in peace, was part African via his mother, but the seed came from his father, which settles that. His hair was not kinky and was not fully African, yet he lived amongst our race and passed for us because we are so ignorant to who anyone is and get upset when people continue to use us as a doormat. Just because people have heavy melanin in their skin and wear braids does not make them a member of our race. This writer will enter a homemade video by Mr. DeWitt, Adamus' father, rest in peace, and when you see the hair texture will add to this writer's claims that other melanin carrying, people have indeed have been used by the negative forces of nature to confuse us and take out our identities. Let this be remembered well. All right, this is the video where you can find it at, and I will insert it in at this point.
Hey, I'm gonna ask you a question. Huh? Do you guys love each other?
Yeah.
Who's the greatest star in the world? Huh?
You?
Oh, he doesn't know that guy. Huh? Sorry.
Go. Now, wait a minute, Aramis, stop. Aramis. Make a film, start dancing, go over there. Come out, I'm fresh and stuff, now start doing your dance.
Let me say, introducing Aramis.
Introducing the Rocking Brothers, Aramis Asgedom and Samuel Asgedom. Come on, Baba.
MS. Okay, let's go.
Yep.
Hi. I love you.
Love you too.
What you guys doing?
Watching TV, playing a video game, kind of washing the dishes. So looking at the calendar today is
Yes.
Para el juego de Homo. Sí, va a hacerlo.
برتع كده الله خبوك الماس سليبيكا هاي دون تعندلا مسكا بو كمان فتي غاز مرة
Book,
the book.
You see how I like that more?
Yeah. See, you're learning. That's great. Oh, now let him do it. They name it Friday and Wednesdays. Mm-hmm. Good.
The best.
And me, you feeling better?
Yeah, easy. I'm blessed, man. Mm-hmm.
Sure. Yeah.
Top notch.
Top notch.
So I'm
excruciating
pain in each shoulder.
Mm-hmm.
I'm alright.
No! What do you want? Shower things up, what do you want? Shower things up? What do you want?
Come back with knockouts.
The truth in the making. Easy. It's flowing nice too. What's up, Daddy? Where we at, man?
This is my jaja, the Ramanda.
That's fine, man.
What about you?
Let's continue. Look at this next example. Two Eritrean females that are wearing braids. They are not African, as clear as it should be. Now look at Obama's daughters below. There's no way these two females are African American. They look more related to the female Eritreans above. As a matter of fact, they are not the children of the Obamas, according to certain sources. All right, so, but when you look at these here, these are not African features. Look at these, you can see it. More around the Hindu branch, if anything. But we know that this is not Michelle, this is Michael, and this is just a little bit of work being done. So nobody's fooled by this. All right, let's look into this real quick. All right, so for those of you who know, you know. All right, so here you have Malia Obama, but this is who they're saying is the father, Marty Nesbitt, who are close friends of the Obamas. He has Sasha Obama, and then this is who they claim is her mother, Anita Blanchard Nesbitt. No known photos exist of Michelle, while pregnant, none. This is the youngest picture that they got all the way back. So all this supposed to have been some big part of the scheme to bring Obama in to look somewhat American and love the country and all that other stuff like that. But for those who know what's going on with this, you know. I'm not going to go into that here. Now, whether you accept these are the true parents, they look more alike these other people than who we've been told are their parents. Moving on. Tiffany Haddish. Her hair is not kinky either. Early life, Haddish was born and raised in South Central Los Angeles, California. Her father, to see Haye Rader Haddish, rest in peace, who was a refugee from Eritrea, was of Ethiopian Jewish heritage. Her mother, Leola, was an African-American small business owner from a Christian family. Tiffany Haddish is officially an Eritrean citizen. This is her father. So again, when you can look at the hair and the nose, all these features are very different. All right. Notice his curly hair. The same way the other individuals above, used the African woolly hair race to make money imitating us. Mrs. Haddish did the same thing. Many of her movies, she portrayed woolly haired black women from the hood or just ratchet acting. She doesn't mock her people on her father's side. Rest in peace. Just reason on that. Finally, the last image, and we will move to the next topic. All right. So now we're talking about the late Haile Selassie. Now look at Selassie's face before we get into the picture. See the nose and the mouth? Now look at Tiffany Haddish's father. See? These the same people. These are not us. And that's a problem because a lot of us just don't look into the scientific part of things and think because people were raised in your country or your continent or your neighborhood and they got dark skin, do you think they you? That's not 100% legit. That's like talking about wearing a condom all the time and you think that it's 100%. It's not. It's not. All right, so let's look real good at Mr. Haile Selassie. Rest in peace. You can see that curl. Ain't no kinks in there. There's no kinks. No kinks. All right, here's a younger picture. Curls, no kinks. There's no kinks there. Just because he was born in Ethiopia, that don't make him African. The same way black people will sit here and be like, yeah, you know, when Caucasians from South Africa say we're African because we're born in Africa, and they be like, no, y'all not. Because we can see it with other people. But when it comes to people that's wearing melanin, it's like y'all minds just don't work. All right. Once again, no kinky hair. And this man, rest in peace, is called an emperor and king of Africa. People are those who believe this madness. The last Ethiopian emperor. So those of us who understand what Noon is and how Ethiopia is really defined, he was the emperor of that country that they're calling Ethiopia. But this is not the king and emperor of Ethiopian people. The black race conditions have not improved since many movements have emerged from following and worshiping this man who was definitely not African or from our race. This is scientifically not sound, and why we need to correct this madness. Our race has its own natural kings and queens that come from our race, not others who invaded and immigrated into Africa and set up shop the same way they do in our neighborhoods. We are surrounded by non-kinky-haired humans who only take from us economically, mentally, spiritually, physically. Then add that to the already present monkeys on our back. It's why we can't get right. Mankind has practiced discrimination against Nubians as far back as their history can be found. Now it is time for us Nubians to reciprocate by destroying the one-sidedness of that biasness. That is to say, the god Nupu and Noon, which commands us to treat people of other races like they treat us, means be a perfect racist and practice racism the way it should be practiced, that is equally. One side of racism, the way mankind practice it, is wrong. There's nothing wrong with racism if it is equal racism, the kind that maintains this warning to people of other races: I will not exploit you, and don't you exploit me. I will not proselyte you or teach you my information, and you don't try to proselyte me, meaning teach their information, which they've been doing, bringing in their alien religions, they sick, crazy culture. Like right now, they pushing transgenderism and making it where kids can choose if they want to be of a get a sex change. Target just lost $10 billion in 10 days because they got a section in their stores that's pushing gay pride and sex toys in the children's section. All of this is part of mankind, meaning non-African culture. All right, so this is what we're being subjected to, and it's one-sided because none of us voted on none of that, and you shouldn't have to vote on certain things. But again, this is the maladies and the problems of being under other races of people who are pushing this stuff because that's part of their culture. You understand? Not saying black people don't practice some of this perversion. I'm saying that when you're talking about a culture, when you go back before our race started becoming mentally deficient, reasonability wise, and fell into victimhood because it was ordained by nature to do so, right, for a certain amount of time, this is what the other races are doing. So that's a part of racism, because they're pushing what their race wants, right? And that's biased and it's unequal. So equal racism is saying, listen, I ain't with any of that crap you doing, and that will affect my race in the negative, which we all experience. Then we supposed to have the same right to say, and they supposed to respect that. That's a part of racism, in this equalness. But what they're doing now, producing and promoting everything that they want, the same way they created an Asian bill and protect them, they didn't suffer none of the stuff we went through all of these years over here. But that's called one-sided racism. They'll look out for other mankind races that don't have kinky hair before they look out for us. All right? These are scientific, historical facts. Nobody can deny that. All right? I will not try to pervert or sex your females, and don't you try to pervert or sex my females. I will not try to take what rightly belongs to you, and don't you try to take what belongs to me. This is the way to practice equal racism with people of other races. Okay, that's positive. Now about count number four, number 10. Every race on planet Earth till this day is guilty of taking what we have and also ruling us in the most negative fashion. Listen to reason. Nupu has already been conceived, is now beginning to emanate and gestate by mentally resurrecting human beings, as well as universe bodies such as the stars, planets, and satellites. We human beings must let Noon, the positive signs of Nupu, be our guide. And this is why I put this in here, because in the Nine Ball that was written in 71 and 72, it says this right here. That is to say, the guide, and I put in parentheses, Nupu and Noon, which command us to treat people of other races like they treat us. And when you go to the nature books written by Afro-Udu, the same person, this falls in what? The commandment laws. And that's why I did that, because it says what? The guide commands us. So this is only right that it would be in the commandment laws of Noon. Okay? All right. We human beings must let Noon, the positive signs of Nupu, be our what? God, because Noon is designed to put nature knowledge in chronological order and our minds in order along with it. Hence, do not let other information confuse you, anymore, because the aim and objective of the negative force of nature is to do just that. Keep us confused and confounded. Pronouncing the name Nupu often and nine times or more magnifies and unites nine ether mind. And nine ether mentality acts as our spirit beings and guide together with the positive forces side of the negative. If you are a Nunabu and adherent to the science of sound right reason known as Noon, this writer repeats, Nupu is developing in the universe orbs such as the sun, earth, and moon, and also in the atmosphere, and likewise in the minds of persons and things. The conception of Nupu is like the birth of Nupu to us human beings, because the universe physical birth of Nupu does not occur until all existence reaches 0.6 east on the smart circle of order. Let it be remembered. Introduction to the Nature of Nature, Book 2, pages 167 to 168. Here are two basic hair type charts that most hair can be put in. All right, so you got 1A, which you could tell this is the Caucasian, 1B, Oriental, 1C, I think Kim Kardashian, Romanian, 2A, I don't know what particular race is, but this is how they do it though. Then we got Chile from TLC, she's half black, and I think she has Caucasian father. I don't know which one we have. This is I forgot the singer name, at Taylor Swift. And then you have 3 Ahab, which is the singer Maya. 3B, I think she's mixed too. I don't know her name. This is the actress. She's mixed. And 4A again, this is curly hair. Once you start, and this is black people start coming in right here. 4A, 4B, and 4C. This is the African hair type right here. All right? Here's a more clear, distinct the way to look at it. So everybody we've seen is mankind have be from 1 to 3B. So 3B pretty much kind of stops here. We have, she's black too, but her hair's curly. But when you start getting into those of us who have that kink in it, it's mostly, most sometimes 4A, but mostly 4A, 4B, and 4C. All right? So here, they got it from 1A to 3B, and then you got 3C. You can see the curls on the 4A and 4B. So these are the four main types or categories that they have. Straight hair, wave hair, curl hair, then coily, which turns in like a coil. All right? So we need to learn these things to better be able to properly identify other races. All right? All right, listen to Sound Right Cosmic Reason. 3C to 4B is the place that most African kingly and queenly hair fits into this divine category. Listen to reason. The flocculi on the surface of the sun are the hair of the sun, and it looks like spirals or springs as shown in figure 15 of this paragraph. Figure 15 shows a strand or grain of the flocculus. All right, so this is how hair looks on our head and also on the sun. Nine in original space, nine in original matter, and nine in original time, the positive. And the other ones in reverse is the negative, six in space, six in matter, and six in time, okay? The solenoid, the Ethiopian race symbol of originality, power, uniqueness, and identity. Ethiopian race has kinky hair because we inherited our hair flocculi from the sons who grew the universes by first growing themselves. And the writer repeats, the sons are self-created, self-grown by help of space and time, the laws and cycles of nature, plus suitable conditions. The origin number of the Ethiopian race is 999, and the solenoid, see figure 15. The hair, the solenoid in this paragraph is shown here, is three nines united, one atop of the other. Let it be remembered, always let it be known. Introduction to the Nature Book, one page is 153 to 154 in part. Remember this writer, Ju Satuna Tarkino Unu Nupu, along with writers Afro Unu, Jipu, and Sipu's writings, have stated and proven the stars in the heavens have the same kinky hair. And these are three of the books that are written by Afro Unu, Jipu, and Sipu that I base my writings on, along with the mentalities and the research. Introduction to the Nature, Book 1, written by Afro Unu. Introduction to the Nature, Book 2, written by Afro Unu. Introduction to the Nature, Book 3, written by Afro Unu. Following are books written by this writer about Ethiopian African kinky haired people of planet Earth. You got Our Hair 1, Our Hair 2, and Reason, Son of Ray, Our Son as Creator. And also the Solar Cycles and the Coming of Nupu book. These books can be found on lulu.com under Tarkino Nupu. More information can be found on this writer's YouTube as well.